Let's continue our exploration about Windows 65, and today I will summarize what we know about Windows 65, and I will answer several questions that coming into my YouTube channel. Before that, don't forget to subscribe this channel so you can get the new update and notification for the new video. Last week, Microsoft announced Windows 65, a desktop operating system running in cloud, or also known as Cloud PC. You can access Windows 65 using web browser or using Microsoft Remote Desktop application at anywhere and anytime. Since it's running on cloud, other than you can access Windows 65 using PC and laptop, you can also access it using Mac device, iPad, or your Android device. All you need is your device, internet connection, and web browser or Remote Desktop application. With Windows 365, we can access desktop OS such as Windows 10 and later Windows 11 along with desktop application. Our experience using application totally same with our regular desktop experience. Moreover, when you disconnect the cloud PC and continue to connect some other time, your desktop was kept just like the time you left it. In one presentation in Microsoft Mechanic channel, it explained that average internet connection speed in United States is around 25 megabytes per second. This speed more than enough to be able to access Windows 65. But if you live in the developing country just like me, with 10 megabytes per second or less, it's still sufficient to access Windows 65, as long as you don't do activity that require a lot of pixel change per second in your desktop, such as watching video. Basic infrastructure of Windows 65 is Azure Cloud. So, if we assume it will use similar technology, it will be similar to Windows 10 VM in Azure, which only require 1 megabyte per second or 2. For you to do a standard desktop activity such as document editing, or even you can do coding in cloud PC as long as it's not do a lot of animation, I think 10 megabyte per second is enough, or maybe 20 if you want watch a video on cloud PC, since it requires a lot of pixel change per second. Microsoft will launch Windows 65 in August 2nd, so we can expect more information in the next few weeks. Okay, let's answer several questions about Windows 65 that you guys left in my YouTube channel. The first question is from Kaushik. Is it free? Any idea? My answer is no, it will not be free. If we refer to the one of the first article, Windows 65 business with 2 vCPU, 4GB RAM and 128GB storage will be charged around $31 per user per month. Microsoft offer Business Edition and Enterprise Edition of Windows 65. As for today, we only got information Business Edition limited around 300 users, just like Microsoft 365. Second question from Shamil Jaini. Can we mine on this? My answer is, I don't think it will. Current main objective of Windows 65 is about hybrid work. Imagine this is like business laptop, yeah, in Microsoft Cloud. As we know, a business laptop just like this is not designed for game or mining since it's not include a good GPU. Yeah. Let's see a traction of Windows 65. If it's good, Microsoft probably will release consumer version of Windows 65 targeting for gaming or mining. The third question from Kyle Cruz. How will it be different from Citrix, Amazon Workspace, Parallel, and the likes? Okay, I believe you refer as Windows as a desktop OS in cloud. The main difference is price predictability. Okay, Amazon Workspace and Azure Virtual Desktop is basically a virtual machine that charge customer per hourly per use. Okay. With this model, you can use VM strictly. If you use this VM strictly in the business hour, yeah, the price range pretty much the same. But you should discipline about when to turn on and turn off the VM. The main idea of Windows 65 is more about cloud PC. You can access anywhere and anytime, and simplifying to manage the license. Yeah, this method is hard to achieve if you use Azure Virtual Desktop or Amazon Workspace. The fourth question from Asif Samsi. Will I be able to use my office laptop that doesn't support Windows 11? Yes, I think so. Microsoft will release Windows 365 at August 2nd. At the time, you may only able to use Windows 10 in Windows 365. But right after Windows 11 release, Microsoft will roll out Windows 11 to Windows 365 customer. So basically, you can use Windows 11 even if your office laptop is kind of an old laptop, yeah. It's including me. This laptop is ThinkPad X270. Last month, Microsoft released Windows 11 Upgrade Check app, and my laptop it was not passed the test. But with Windows 65, I don't need to worry about this. And use my current laptop, yeah, to use Windows 11 via Windows 65. Next question from Razat. Will I get virtual GPU acceleration? Like I have to pay virtualized version of GTX or RX card for my cloud computer? Well, similar with previous question, I don't think GPU acceleration will be available in Windows 65. At least for now or near future. If your objective is gaming, Microsoft also offer xCloud. It's a whole different offer with Windows 65, but you can do gaming in the cloud. Next question from Kaustav Duta. Isn't it just VM instead of Windows Server OS? Are they going to run regular Windows? Just like previous question, the underlying technology was the same. Yeah. It's Azure Virtual Machine with desktop OS on the top of it. The concept is called Virtual Desktop Infrastructure or VDI. Microsoft offers VDI as Azure Virtual Desktop and AWS also offers it as Amazon Workspace. Both cloud offer pay per use. Windows 365 offers a flat price per user per month. So we can get predictable costs, yeah, and better management, better license allocation, and also it's so much like a software as a service. Last question from Peter Kwan. Finally, I don't have to turn on incognito mode. Yes, you don't need to turn on your incognito mode for activity about research purpose. Okay, stay tuned for this channel for the next update. You can ask the question in comment section. I will try my best to answer it. Yeah, and sorry for my English. This is my first video in English. Okay, that's it for today.